Are you a beginner investor who's ready to explore the altcoin market? In this video, I am going to show you how to use the Binance exchange to buy your first altcoin, coming up right now. Welcome back, Satoshi Scopers, Alan here. If you're new to this channel and you want to learn more about trading, investing, or anything else related to cryptocurrency, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss anything. So if you're watching this video, you are probably invested in your first Bitcoin and you're ready to explore those altcoin gains. So if you want to do this, the small altcoins you won't find on large platforms like Coinbase, where you can swap your fiat for crypto coins. They only have larger coins like Bitcoin, Ethereum, Litecoin, and Bitcoin Cash as of right now. However, if you haven't got your first Bitcoin yet, you can check out a video below where I talk you through exactly how to buy your first Bitcoin on Coinbase. Now, moving on, there are many exchanges which you can purchase altcoins from. However, many of them have small volumes and I don't like to use them personally. The three main ones with bigger volumes that I like and I believe is also safe are Bitfinex, Bittrex and Binance. And I have also done another video, link below again, on Bittrex. That's one of the other main ones I like to use daily when I trade. So in this video, we'll explore Binance. It's becoming my favorite platform to trade and purchase altcoins, as there are many more advantages to this compared to other exchanges like Bittrex. So first of all, the fee, right? The fee, you're only going to pay 0.1% as opposed to 0.25% on Bittrex. So it's got a much lower fee. And if you're day trading or swing trading, you're going to save a lot on fees alone. Secondly, Binance, most of the time, will have new coins listed on its platform quicker than exchanges like Bittrex. Not always, but more often than not. Thirdly, Binance allows you to withdraw 2 Bitcoin worth of cryptocurrency per day without having to verify your account whatsoever. So you just simply sign up and you're able to deposit and withdraw right away. So that's a big positive where you don't have to provide them your private information if you don't want to. And lastly, I just feel like the Binance team is more responsive and they act more like a community where they come out with a lot of news updates and events. They also do a lot of giveaways and competitions, and also they do a coin of the month where people get to vote on what coin they want to be listed on Binance, and the ones with the most vote will be listed. So they're getting us involved with their community. So firstly, you come to www.binance.com and I suggest you type this into the box manually yourself and bookmark it. Don't search it on Google, as there will be ads and other sites trying to direct you to another link and could possibly be a scam. And you can see at the top here, there's a login or register button. You can go through there or you can use the link that I have below for you. That's a referral link and I appreciate the support if you want to use it. If not, no worries. So once you have filled out your information in the register section, then you will have a live Binance account. And once you log into account, you will see the dashboard and you can see the level one is for any accounts that just sign up. You can get a 24-hour withdrawal limit of 2 BTC. So you don't even have to provide any information and you can use it already. But if you want a higher withdrawal limit, then you can submit some personal details and documents and you can increase that limit to 100 BTC. So the next thing I strongly recommend you do before doing anything else is to register for your Google authentication down here. So I've already done it, but you should do it immediately and download the app through the App Store or through the Google Play Store. And now that's done, let's talk about the fees on Binance. So you can see this button here that says using BNB to pay for fees, 50% discount, and you click it to turn it on. So what that means is you need to buy a certain number of BNB tokens. This is the Binance token. So when you have it, it will just be deducted every time you purchase something, and this will reduce your fees to half of what it normally is. So let me quickly show you what Binance have said about it. So fee for trading, is 0.1% trading fee. If you have a BNB, we will use BNB to pay for transaction fees as default. So a 50% discount will be applied. So your fee will now be reduced to 0.05%, which is 5 times less than Bittrex. So you're saving a lot of money here. And there's no fee for deposit, and for withdrawal, there's just a transaction fee, which every exchange has. Now, more details about the BNB token. So the discount rate for BNB tokens reduces each year, from 50% the first year to 25% and down until the fifth year where there's no discount left. So if you want to see exactly how they calculate the fees, you can go down to this section and have a read of how they do it. So in summary, what you need to do is buy your BNB tokens and then click this on button. Then you will have your fees reduced by 50% to 0.05%, which will save you lots of money. So make sure you do this. So the next thing I want to show you is the news section up here. They have very meaningful news that come out, like when a new coin is listed here, or when their community coin of the month, this is round 6, is listed. So they give you updates constantly, and they come out with big news like this one, Binance Chain. So Binance is coming up with their own Binance blockchain. So this section is very useful, and make sure you keep yourself up to date and have a read once in a while. So the next step now, we're going to deposit money into Binance. So what you do with this is go to funds, click on balance. It'll bring up this page, and you can see I have some funds in here already. But if you want to see exactly how to deposit your Bitcoin from an exchange like Coinbase, I've done a video and I'll give you the link in the description below, and you can check out where I show you a live example of transferring, and if you're not comfortable in doing this and you want to be guided more step by step. So the first thing before you deposit money into any account, you want to make sure that if you're depositing Bitcoin, you must deposit one wallet that is Bitcoin to another Bitcoin wallet. You can't mix and match or swap them around. You can't use a Bitcoin wallet and transfer it into an Ethereum wallet. This is not going to work, and you're going to lose your money. So that's a very important note to make. So right now, I want to deposit BTC, which is Bitcoin. So what I always do is the first step, I type in BTC in here. So it reduces the number of coins that are left there. So then what you do is you press deposit. Then this page comes up, and you can come down to here and copy the address. And then you paste this onto your wallet where you are transferring your money from. So once you have done that, then you press OK and you wait for the Bitcoin to be completed and confirmed into your Binance account. So now that you have your Bitcoin deposited into your Binance account, we can go and buy our first altcoin. So the next step is to go to exchange, and you can either choose the basic or the advanced. So the only difference is basic does not have indicators where you can input it into your chart, whereas advanced does. And I'll show you the advanced version. So this is what I mean by the indicators. You can click on that, and you can use indicators like MACD or EMAs or Bollinger Bands. This is useful for when you are a technical trader and you are looking for entry and exit points, and you can draw up charts on here. So what you can see on the screen is the last price, the 24-hour change, 24-hour high, 24-hour low, and the volume in the last 24 hours. And if you're looking to change a coin to a different coin, you simply click on here, and you can choose your pairing. So it has BTC, Ethereum pairing, BNB pairing, and USDT. Obviously, Bitcoin has the most number of pairings, so that's how I normally trade with the BTC. And especially now that the cost of transferring Bitcoin from exchanges like Coinbase has reduced significantly because of the segregated witness, I'd like to use Bitcoin now. And Ethereum would have a lot of pairings, but still less than Bitcoin, and so is BNB and USDT. There's only 6 pairings here right now. So stick with Bitcoin if you can, as it has everything. So now you can see here, these are the sell orders on the order books. This screen is the buy orders, and here is called the spread, is the difference between the buy and the sell. And this is the price buy and sell history, where the most recent buy and sell orders will appear. And down here are the different types of orders you can make. You can do limit orders, market orders, or stop limits. And here is where you see all the trades that you have done and all the funds that you currently have by clicking on these different tabs. So let me now quickly explain to you the difference between limit, market, and stop limit orders. So the most simplest order is a market order. This is where you're buying from the market. So if you're buying right now, that means you're buying this at 8366. This is the top sell order that someone has put on the books. So you're buying off them. So the advantage of doing this is that your order will be filled immediately. However, you're paying a little bit higher as you're paying on top of the spread. So 8374. But if you're willing and you have more patience, then you would go to the limit order. This is where you set a maximum price you're willing to pay. For example, if I'm only happy to pay 8,000, then you put that there. You put the amount you want, and there's a neat feature here where you can choose the percentage of Bitcoin you own that you want to use for this transaction. So you can see the advantage of using a limit order as opposed to a market order is that you're going to be able to buy it at a lower price. However, if the price does not come down and hit your 8,000 here, then you're going to risk not getting your buy order in. And if the coin goes up, then you've missed out on that profit. So you got to weigh it up which one you prefer to do. And lastly is the stop limit. So this is just a more complicated version of a limit order, except the only thing added here is the stop or the trigger, whatever you want to call it. So this trigger is where you want your buy or sell to appear on the order books when you're ready to buy or to sell your coin. So let's say, for example, I want to set a stop at 8354. Then you click on that, and I want to set the limit, which is the buy price, at 8360. So that means once the price of this coin hits 8354, I want to buy it at 8360. This is very useful for when you're not watching the screen. You could be asleep, you could be working, or you could be out doing your workout. It doesn't matter. The order will trigger and it will fill for you. So I don't want to take up much more of your time, so we'll leave it at that for now. But if you want to know exactly how to make a limit, market, or stop limit buys, or even setting proper stop losses, or taking your profit and setting a stop sell, and I'll put a link below where it leads you to a video where I show you live step by step on how to make all these buys and sells in case you're not sure of how to do it and you just want to see how it's done firsthand. Question of the day: what is another altcoin exchange that you have seen and want to try out the most? Let me know in the comment section below. So thanks so much for checking out this video, and make sure to hit that like button if you thought this video was valuable. And always remember to follow the sats.